Hello students, I am Dr. B.K. Singh, Professor of Civil Engineering at Ajay Kumar Garg Engineering College, Ghaziabad. So, this will be the unit number 4, lecture number 7, I will be discussing mixed design using American Concrete Institute method, ACI. Okay. So, if you see here, so, in American Concrete Institute method, first step you have to collect the data. So, what are the data to be collected? So, in this method we need a fineness modulus of selected fine aggregates. So, you have to whatever the aggregate is there. So, based on that you need the fineness modulus, then unit weight of dry rotted coarse aggregate. So, size of the aggregate you have to decide, maximum size of aggregate. Depends on the requirement. Suppose RCC work is there, then we can select 20 mm and downside aggregate. And if pre-stressed concrete is there, then we need a high grade, high strength concrete or concrete of even a standard concrete of higher side. So, in that case, if you are using a 12.5 mm downside aggregate, then it will be better. So, like that. Then you need a specific gravity of coarse and fine aggregate in surface saturated dry condition, absorption characteristic of both coarse and fine aggregate, because at dry condition how much percentage of water it is going to absorb, and situation, suppose you are getting from the field, how much percentage of water is there in the coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. A specific gravity of cement, brand of cement, so that you have to do. So, then that once you got the data, then we have to get the minimum strength specified. How much, because it depends on the grade of concrete, you have to take the mean target strength using the standard deviation or coefficient of variation method. Okay. So, this one I have taken from the IS 10262 2019. So, this equation will be there. So, this is the statistical constant. So, India our value is for 95% confidence limit, because only 5% of the material may fall below the characteristic strength. Okay. And EFCK here, Indian standard, that is based on cube strength. That is based on cube strength. So, cube of size 150 by 150 by 150 is considered. Okay. But if you see the ACI, American Concrete Institute, they consider cylinder strength. They consider the cylinder strength. Suppose diameter is 150, so their height will be 300. Okay. So, they do test on this one, and due to the Platen effect, a strength of this cube will be higher than the strength of the cylinder. So, here in India we have a practice of assessing the strength of concrete on 150 mm by 150 mm by 150 mm size cube. So, that is why I have taken this, because I have just little bit I will try to use the Indian standard. Okay. Okay. So, value of x is given here, because the minimum of that much value we have to take. So, suppose we have a M30 grade of concrete. So, M30 grade of concrete means we have to use a value of x equal to 6.5. Okay. So, this thing we are supposed to do. So, that will I will discuss one by one. And suppose we want to convert, suppose you have a cylindrical strength. So, that cylindrical strength, this value, suppose you want equivalent cube strength, okay. Because our designation is M10, M50, M20, like this, up to M20 is the ordinary concrete, and M25 to M60 grade is a standard concrete, and M65 to M100 is high strength concrete. Okay. So, our Indian standard is having based on cube of size 150 mm by 150 mm by 150 mm. But if you see the UK, we have to use the cylindrical strength. So, that equivalent cube strength, you can say this is nothing but 5 by 4 times of cylindrical strength. Cylindrical compressive strength. Okay, so this is given in the code. So that much can be taken, or roughly you can take around whatever the cube strength is there, you can take about 0.80. Okay, so 80% you can take in actual testing, but if you see the Indian standard, equivalent is 5 by 4, means about 25%. Okay, and if you do not have the standard deviation, if the value of contractor is not known, in that case what we have to do, we have to assume certain standard deviation depends on the quality of the contractor. So, if the quality of contractor is not is good, in that case this value you can take. If the their quality control at the site is not good, then that case we have to increase this standard deviation by 1. So, let us say suppose I want to do M25 grade concrete and a standard deviation assumed, you have to assume the standard 4. If quality control is not good, then you increase 1. So, you have to take 5 Newton per mm square standard deviation. So, that depends on the quality of contractor. So, if you are getting a well shaped frequency curve, so distribution curve, then you can say that is having a good quality control. Okay. So, then once you know the strength of the concrete, with the help of this, suppose you got the mean target strength. So, once you got the target strength, so based on that, we have to refer the table which is given in Indian standard. But here, if you like, you can change this FCK, because you have, I have given already the relation between the cube strength and cylindrical strength. So, suppose M30 grade concrete, if you want to say, means what will be there? So, this is a cube strength is 30. So, that you multiplied by 0.8. So, this is nothing but 24 Newton per mm square. So, this is the reduction. Okay. So, equivalent cube strength will be less. Suppose this is a cylindrical strength. Suppose this is a cube strength. So, this is your cylindrical strength. So, cylindrical strength will be lesser with respect to cube strength due to the Platen effect. So, that had been discussed during the testing of concrete, testing on hardened concrete. Okay. So, as you have determined the water cement ratio, you have to find the water cement ratio from SEI to 11.1. So, there depends on the grade of concrete, like MPA we have 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, like that. So, based on that we have to select, say I have a this category. So, we have two types of concrete, one is air intertent concrete and another is non-air intertent concrete. So, based on that which type of aggregate you want, concrete you want. Suppose, I want to design non-air intertent concrete, say M30. So, minimum value of average compressive strength, if it is 30, so in that case water cement ratio is minimum 0.55 you have to select. So, this strength is nothing but your cylindrical strength. This is nothing but cylindrical strength water cement ratio. Okay. And here this is a MPA given. So, this is not M30 grade concrete, it is not a M30 grade concrete. So, if you want M30 grade concrete, so this divide by 0.80. Okay. So, this will be around this value will be higher. Okay, so that may be around more than 35. Okay, so that you have to consider here while we are designing the water cement ratio. Once again, as you have determined water cement ratio from a strength point of view, then we have to decide from durability requirement, a special exposure condition. So, American SEI course, they have three conditions, 1, 2, 3, and if you consider with our Indian standard, we have 5 exposure condition: mild, moderate, severe, very severe and extreme. So, based on that we have to compare, and from there you have to consider your minimum water cement ratio. So, suppose our exposed to brackish or sea water or exposed to fresh water, so that you can say it is more or less like moderate condition. Okay. So, this is nothing but moderate condition. So, if the concrete is like that, so you can have a equivalent nomenclature with respect to Indian standard concrete. Okay. So, from here you have to also calculate the water cement ratio from durability requirement, means exposure condition, okay. So, out of this, whichever is giving the lower value, that you are supposed to contribute. So, adopt lower value out of a strength consideration and durability consideration, So, then decide maximum size of aggregate to be used. Generally for RCC work you can take 20 mm, and pre-stressed concrete you can take, even you can take 20 mm, but you have to design. But if you want a very good quality of concrete like high strength concrete, then it is always better you go 10 mm and downside aggregate. Okay. So, that you will be decide based on the availability. So, once you know that, then decide workability in terms of slump for the type of job in hand. So, general guidelines has been given in SEI code. So, from that if you see here, so reinforced foundation 22 and wall and footing 20 to 80 mm, like plain footing cajuns substructure was 20 to 80 mm, beams and reinforced wall 20 to 100 mm. So, like this they have given certain value of slump value. So, for Indian equivalent, if table is not there, we can use this table. So, this table is given in IS 456. This recommendation can also be used here. Okay. So, like this table, if you see, you have to refer the IS 456. So, IS 456, you can get this value. So, there, from there also you can decide okay, what should be our value of slump value for our given type of work. So, now we have determined water cement ratio based on strength and durability requirement. Now, we have decided what should be their slump value and maximum size of the coarse aggregate, maximum nominal size of the coarse aggregate. So, once we have decided, then we have to consider dry bulk volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of concrete. So, this one will depend on fineness modulus of sand, means fineness modulus of fine aggregate. So, this is a fineness modulus of fine aggregate, okay, sand, and here nominal size of maximum size of coarse aggregate. What is the maximum size of aggregate? Okay. So, that you have to consider, and depends on that. Suppose our fineness modulus of sand is between 2.40, and say our maximum size of aggregate is 20 mm. So, in that case you can take 0.666 times the bulk volume of dry eroded coarse aggregate per unit volume of concrete for fineness modulus of sand of suppose this our value is between 2.4 and 2.60, then in that case we can go for linear interpolation. And here different size of aggregate is 10 mm, 12.5, 20, 25, and this is for mass concrete. So, based on that we are supposed to take the values from this table. So, this table has been given in SEI 211.1. So, this table is not in our Indian standard code. We do not consider the fineness modulus of sand. Okay. So, based on the fineness modulus we even do not consider the dry rotted coarse aggregate. So, that we have to take the standard cylinder, and that standard cylinder we have to compact the coarse aggregate in 3 layers and by putting the water replacement we can find the bulk dry bulk volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of concrete. So, you have to first find the dry bulk volume of concrete coarse aggregate which is not the part of Indian standard code IS 1062-2019. So, that is the difference you can find here. Okay. Then what you have to do, then approximate requirement for mixing water and air content for different workabilities and nominal maximum size of aggregate according to SEI. So, this table you have to suppose to refer, and you have to find the how much water is required for 1 meter cube of concrete. So, here slump value, there are 2 types of concrete is there. So, one is non-air intent concrete and air intent concrete is there. So, here your slump is between 30 to 50 mm, 80 to 100 mm, 150 to 180 mm. And here they are, this table is also giving. So, what should be the entrapped air? What should be the entrapped air? So, depends on the types of aggregate, so maximum size of the aggregate. So, that is ranging with 10 mm, 12.5 mm, 20 mm, 25 mm, up to 150 mm. So, as the size of the aggregate is increasing, entrapped air is going on reducing. Okay. So, let us say I am going to design a concrete with the help of maximum size of aggregate 20 mm. So, for that suppose our slump value for workability requirement for our given job is between 80 to 100 mm. So, how much should be the water content? So, you have to take the water content of 200 kg per meter cube. Okay. So, these are the specification has been given. Similarly, suppose you want to do the air intent concrete, you want to purposely put certain admixtures like aluminum powder you are putting to generate the gas inside the concrete, air inside the concrete, okay, gap inside the concrete. Suppose you have 80 to 100 mm. In that case, this requirement will go to 180. Okay. And here also some recommended average total air content percentage, how much depends on the mild exposure is there, moderate exposure is there, extreme exposure is there. So, they have recommended what should be the about approximate percentage of entrained air inside the concrete. Okay. So, that we are supposed to check. Okay. So, here we have to take this table, this is very very important table. Okay. Similarly, then first estimate of density unit 8 of fresh concrete as given by SEI. So, SEI has given, okay, suppose approximate you have a maximum size of aggregate 20 mm, we have maximum, let us say we have maximum size of aggregate 20 mm. So, what should be for say we have a non-air intent type of concrete. So, what should be the approximate density? So, approximate density will be 2355 as a first approximation we can assume it is a 2355. And if it is air entrained concrete, because certain percentage of air is here, so in that case we can take 2280. So, these are the different tables we have to consider while we are designing the concrete with the help of Indian Concrete Institute. Okay. So, another thing, now we have calculated total water content, and you know the total water content, say we have calculated 200 kg, okay, for M20 and downside aggregate. So, based on that, we have to enter the table with the selected slump and selected maximum size of aggregate. So, table 4 also gives the approximate amount of accidentally entrapped air in non-air entraining concrete. So, we have calculated the total water content. Okay. So, total water content, if you see the table earlier here. Depends on the workability condition, we have calculated this table number 7, sorry, we have to take the table number 7. So, we have need a water of 200 kg per meter cube, 200. So, you can say this is a table number 7 gives the approximate amount of air in non-entrained concrete. So, let us say I have taken a water of 200 kg per meter cube water. So, that is based on maximum size of aggregate. Okay. Then cement content is computed by dividing the total water cement content by the water cement ratio. So, we have water cement ratio. So, water cement ratio. So, say I have water cement ratio of 0.50. So, I want to calculate cement. So, how to calculate cement? So, cement will be nothing but water content divided by water cement ratio. So, this is nothing but 0.50. So, say water content is 200, our water requirement, water cement requirement from durability aspect as well as strength requirement is 0.5. So, what will be its value? This will become 400 kg per meter cube. So, this also you are supposed to calculate. So, after that, the bulk volume of dry rotted coarse aggregate per unit volume of concrete is selected for the particular maximum size of core aggregate and finite modulus of fine aggregate. Okay. So, that we can calculate. So, that we have calculated here. So, bulk volume of So, this one we have calculated from table number 6, table number 6.66. Okay. So, here we need one correction. So, this is from table number 6, the bulk volume of dry rotted coarse aggregate per unit volume of coarse aggregate. So, let us say I am getting 0.666 for different conditions. Now, we have to consider, let us say I have the value of here, how much? 0.66 for this example, say our finest modulus of fine aggregate is 2.4 and maximum size aggregate of 20. So, that value is 0.66. So, 0.66 value we have calculated here. Okay. So, the weight of coarse aggregate per cubic meter of concrete is calculated by multiplying the bulk volume with bulk density. So, weight of coarse aggregate, how can we are going to find out? So, we have coarse aggregate. So, we have the value of, let us say, we have got the value of here 0.66. Let us say for 20 mm aggregate, we got the value of 0.66. So, this 0.66 multiply by the aggregate you have selected. Our bulk density of the concrete, you have to select certain value. Okay. So, that is supposed to be given in the data. Starting, suppose you see here, so we need one data unit weight of dry rotted coarse aggregate. So let us say, I assume it is a 1600 kg. Let us say, just for example, I am taking by doing the experiment, we have got 1600 kg per meter cube. Okay. So, okay. So, here we have to calculate by 1600 value. So, once you know this value, you just multiply, you can get the weight of, you can get weight of coarse aggregate, very simple. Okay. Sorry. Then we go for the solid volume of coarse aggregate in 1 cubic meter of concrete is calculated by knowing the specific gravity of Ca. So, now we calculate the absolute volume. Okay. So, if you want to calculate the absolute volume and we have the specific gravity of coarse aggregate and we know the coarse aggregate. So, what is the absolute value? So, absolute volume of coarse aggregate, you can find out weight of coarse aggregate divided by specific gravity divided by 1000. Okay. So, weight or mass of coarse aggregate in kilogram force and specific gravity, that much you are going to get the meter cube of this volume. So, similarly, you can find out what should be the volume of cement, absolute volume. So, cement, similarly, you can get the absolute or solid volume of cement, you can calculate. So, what is the volume of cement that you can get? Weight of cement divided by a specific gravity of cement divided by 1000. So, in 1 meter cube, what should be this value? So, this value you have calculated in meter cube. Similarly, you can calculate volume of water. So, now you need volume of water. So, that will be nothing but weight of water divided by this specific gravity is 1 divided by 1000. So, this much volume you are going to get meter cube volume of water. Similarly, we have air. So, depends on the say we have a 2%. Suppose you have a 2%. So, if you have a 2% air, so their volume of air will become 0.02 meter cube. So, now you have to add all this. After adding this, you can get suppose you want to find the weight of fine aggregate. So, fine aggregate weight you can calculate weight of the fine aggregate you can get. So, first you find the volume of sand. So, volume of sand, how you are going to get? That is nothing but 1 minus volume of cement coarse aggregate, volumes coarse aggregate, cement, water, air, etcetera. Suppose admixture is there, that also you have to take. So, you got the volume of sand. So, once you know the volume of sand, so just you can multiply this. Once you know the volume, so you can get the weight. So, how to get the weight? So, weight of fine aggregate you can calculate equal to volume of absolute volume of sand fine aggregate guna a specific gravity into 1000. So, that much kilogram of fine aggregate you can get. So, based on that you can design your concrete mixed design with the help of SCI code. So now we have understood SCI method of mixed design. Thank you.